हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एजुकेशन हेल्पर्स अकाडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक एनालिसिस। द चैप्टर वी वुड हैव टू डिस्कस द थ्योरी ऑफ डिमांड, हाउ द कंज्यूमर हैज टू बिहेवियर इन गेटिंग द मैक्सिमाइजेशन ऑफ हिज सेटिस्फैक्शन, टू डिस्कस डिफरेंट थ्योरीज, बिहेवियर ऑफ द कंज्यूमर, that is the indifference curve theory and reveal preference curve theory. So first we have to discuss the theory of demand. The theory of demand is to determine the various factors that affect demand. The demand is multivariate relationship that is determined by the many factors simultaneously. Some of the important determinants of the market demand of particular product are its own price, consumer's income, prices of other commodities, consumers' taste and preferences, income distribution, total population, consumers' wealth, credit availability, government policy, and the past levels of the demand and income. According to these factors, the demand curve is slope downward slope. To change in the demand to determine the factors affected. Right? In traditional theory of demand has concentrated on four of the above determinants: the price of the commodities, other price, income and taste preferences, so on. Some of the other factors have been introduced in the theory of demand recently. We will first examine the traditional static theory of demand. Subsequently, we will briefly discuss some recent development in this field. So, what are the basic important of this theory of the consumer behavior? So, why you have to discussing about the theory of demand to determine the factors of the economy? So the traditional theory of demand starts with the examination of the behavior of the consumer. Since the market demand is assumed to be the summation of the demands of the individual consumer, being a rational behavior, consumer income and market prices of the various commodities, he plans to spending of his income so as to attain the highest possible satisfaction or utility. This is the axiom of utility maximization. So there are two basic approaches to the problem of comparison of utilities. One is the cardinal approach and the ordinal approach. The cardinal approach, utility is measured cardinally, numerically in terms of the money. The consumer not only knows which one is preferred but also by what amount. The assumptions of this approach are: one is the rationality and cardinal utility, consistent and marginal utility of money. So what is the rationality? Rationality, consumer is a rational, he aims to maximize his utility subject to the constraint imposed by his given income. Second, cardinal utility. Cardinal utility, the utility of the each commodity is measurable. Utility is a cardinal concept. The most convenient measure is in money, the utility is measured by the monetary units of the consumer is prepared to pay for another unit of the commodity. Another important assumption of the constant marginal utility of money. So this assumption is necessary if the monetary unit is used to measure up the utility. The essential features of a standard unit of the measurement is that to be constant. So cardinal approach is measured on the basis of numerically in terms of the measurement of the utility of units. Money in terms of the money. So another important assumption is diminishing marginal utility. The utility gained from the successive units of the commodity diminishes. In other words, the marginal utility of commodity determines as the consumer requires larger quantity of it. This is, you can call it as axiom of diminishing marginal utility. The last, the total utility of the basket of goods depends upon the quantity of the individual commodities. If there are n commodities in the bundle with quantities x1, x2 and xn, the total utility is u is equal to function of x1, x2 and xn. So where the consumer is equilibrium according to the cardinal approach, we begin with the simple model of the single commodity x. The consumer can either buy x or retain on his given income y. Under these conditions of the consumer is in equilibrium. When the marginal utility of X is equated to its market price Px, symbolically we have MuX is equal to Px. If the marginal utility of X is greater than its price, The consumer can increase his welfare by purchasing more units of X. Similarly, if the marginal utility of X is less than its price, the consumer can increase his total satisfaction by cutting down the quantity of X and keeping more of his income unspent. If there are more commodities, the conditions for the equilibrium of the consumer is to equally of the rations of the marginal utility of the individual commodities of their prices. So that in that case, the equation MUX upon by PX is equal to MUY upon by PY is equal to MUN upon by PN. So this is entire the consumer equilibrium on the basis of the cardinal approach. So now we are coming to ordinal approach. In ordinal approach, utility is measured ordinally, that is qualitatively, not numerically and quantitatively. Alternatively, consumer can rank her preferences according to the order the wants to compare, but not in terms of the different amount. There are two different approaches of ordinal theory, that is the indifference curve approach and revealed preference theory approach. So first we have to start with the indifference curve approach or indifference curve theory. The indifference curve approach, consumer is assumed to be rational, so that consumer's objective is to maximize his her utility by choosing a commodity bundle among all other variable commodity bundles. So what are the assumptions of this theory? You can discuss here. One is the rationality, and another one is utility in ordinal, and another one is diminishing marginal rate of substitution. And you can discussing about the total utility of the consumer depends on the quantity of the commodity consume, consistency, and you can discussing about transitivity of the choices. Look at what is the rationality. Rationality, you can observe the consumer is assumed to be rational. He aim is that maximization of his utility. Already we discussed the assumption of the consumer theory, right? So it is assumed that he has full knowledge about all relevant information. That is the basic important of the rationality. As a rational manner, they must have to know all the information about the commodity prices and what the market condition. And second assumption is utility is ordinal. This is the most important of the indifference curve theory. Indifference curve is related to ordinal theory approach. So it is taken in examinatorily to that the consumer can rank his preferences according to the satisfaction. Right? So each basket of goods, you can observe that each level of the satisfaction. So only the ordinal measurement is required in this indifference curve theory assumption. Next assumption is diminishing marginal rate of substitution. In this assumption, preferences are ranked in terms of non-differences curves, which are assumed to be convex to the origin. So we can coming slides we can discussing about why the curve is slope, downward slope, sometimes it is upward slope. Right? So in that case, it implies that convex to the indifference curve, it implies that the slope of indifference curve increase, the slope of indifference is called marginal rate of substitution. The slope is downward slope due to marginal rate of substitution. The indifference curve theory is based on an axiom of diminishing marginal rate of substitution. See the below the graph. Next, fourth one is the total utility of the consumer depends on the quantity of the commodities consumed. U is equal to function of Q1, Q2, Qx, Qs, so on, Qn. So this is some kind of the total utility utilization of all the bundles of the goods and services. Next, last, the assumption is consistency and transitivity of the choice. So this is the most important assumption of this consumer theory, indifference curve approach, according to it is assumed that consumer is consistent in his choices. That is, if in one period of choices bundle A over B, he will not choose B over A in any other period if both bundles are available to him. So the consistency assumption may be symbolically written as if A greater than B, then B not greater than A. So this is the some important assumption of this indifference curve theory. So now you can discussing about indifference curve. What is the indifference curve? The indifference curve, it shows the locus of points of the combination of the bundles to can get the same level of satisfaction to the consumer. So that means the indifference curve, IC1, you can look at in this diagram, shows the downward slope due to the MRS, marginal rate of substitution. What is the marginal rate of substitution? The rate at which the substitute for orange to the bananas. they substitute for one good to another good, that is MRS. The IC curve to slope downward. But some IC curves are IC2 and IC3 curves also there. It is shows that higher level of the indifference curve, it shows higher level of the satisfaction. Lower level of the indifference curve, it shows lower level of the satisfaction. Derivation of the indifference map. An indifference map shows all the indifference curve which rank the preference of the consumer. Combination of the goods laying on a higher indifference curve yield higher level of the satisfaction are preferred. Combinations of the goods on a lower indifference curve yield the lower utility. That means lower indifference curve would give the lower level of satisfaction, higher indifference curve give the higher level of satisfaction. Already we are discussed. So next we are discussing properties of the indifference curve. There are four properties of the indifference curves. One is an indifference curve has a negative slope, which denotes that the quantity of one commodity decreases, the quantity of the other must increase. If the consumer is stay on the same level of the satisfaction, that means the same level of the IC curve, the consumer has to increase one good, he must have to decrease the another good at the same level of the satisfaction. Then only the indifference curve is going to negative slope. Higher indifference curve gives higher level of the satisfaction, already we discussed. The further away from the origin an indifference curve lies, the higher level of the utility denotes bundles of goods and higher indifference curve are preferred by the rational consumer. Third assumption, properties are indifference curves do not intersect. If they did, the point of their interaction would imply two different levels of the satisfaction, which is impossible. The fourth one is the indifference curves are convex to the origin. This implies that the slope of an indifference curve decreases as we move along the curve from the left downward to the right. The modular rate of substitution of commodities is diminishing. This axiom is derived from the introspection, like the law of diminishing marginal utility. So now already we discussed the slope of the indifference curve, you can call it as, that is marginal rate of substitution. What is the marginal rate of substitution? The negative of the slope of the indifference curve at any point is called marginal rate of substitution. And another way, the marginal rate of substitution is the rate at which you can substitute for one good for another good to commodities. X and Y, that is given by the slope of the tangent at the point. So now you can given the equation, the slope of the indifference curve minus negative of dou x, MRS XY. The marginal rate of substitution of X for Y defined as the number of units of the commodity Y that must give up of exchange for an extra unit of the commodity X so that consumer maintain the same level of satisfaction. This is the most important. The consumer has to maintain the same level of satisfaction of the particular IC curve to get the one more unit of good, they must have to giving up of the another good. Next, we are coming to discuss the budget constraint of the consumer. So after knowing the preferences, they must have to know the what his budget, that means what his income to can prefer the different two bundles of the goods. The consumer has a given income which sets limits to his maximization behavior. Income acts as a constraint in the attempt for maximizing utility. The income constraint in the case of two commodities may be written as y is equal to px qx plus py qy. In this equation, you can observe the consumer budget can spending on x good and y good. So here you can discuss, we may present the income constraint graphically by the budget line. So you can depict this diagram, the how the consumer has to spending his income on two goods, that is x good and y good. In x good, number of chocolate bars, and y good you can discuss in number of music downloads, right? So if figure shown at point A and B, point A and B I couldn't mention in the figure, just you can mention that x axis is point A and y axis point B. If you join the points with the line to obtain the budget line whose slope the ratio of price of the two commodities. What is the budget line? The budget line is the ratio of the price of the two goods, x and y goods. Geometrically, the slope of the budget line is OA upon by OB equals to y upon by PY upon by y upon by PX is equal to PX by PY. This PX upon by PY is the ratio of the price of the two commodities, that is called as budget line. Mathematically, the slope of the budget line is the derived the dou qy upon by dou qx is equal to px upon by py. This it is depicted in this figure, the budget line equation. If the consumer has budget is M, that is the money, how he can spend his income and take the two goods. PXX is the price of the good X, he is spending his income. PYY, price of good Y, is spending his income at point L and at point G. If the consumer has to spend the entire income at L, the point M by PX, that means they can spending all his income at point L, that means he getting the more X but zero level of the Y. If suppose the consumer has to get spending all his income M by PY, point G, that means he is spending all his income in Y good, but there is no X good. So H is the point the consumer has to spending his income same proportion of the good X and Y. That's why OA upon by OB, that is PX by PY, is the budget line. That means his income is spending PX X plus PY Y is equal to M. So next, derivation of the equilibrium of the consumer. After knowing that indifference curve preferences of the two bundles and budget line, now you can observe that what is the consumer equilibrium, or you can get in the where the consumer has to get in the maximum satisfaction. If the consumer is in equilibrium, when he is maximizing his utility given his income and market prices. Two conditions must be fulfilled for the consumer to be in equilibrium. One first condition is that marginal rate of substitution is equal to ratio of commodity price. That is, MRSXY is equal to MUX upon by MUY is equal to PX by PY. This is necessary but not sufficient condition for the equilibrium. The another important, the second condition is that the indifference curve be convex to the origin. And this condition is fulfilled by the assumption of diminishing marginal substitution on X and Y, which state that the slope of the indifference decrease as we move along the curve from the left downward to the right. That means first condition must be MRS is equal to PX by PY. Second condition is the indifference curve convex to the origin on the basis of MRS XY diminishing. So in this diagram, you can observe that the graphical presentation of the equilibrium of the consumer. Given the indifference map of the consumer and his budget line, the equilibrium is defined by the point of tangency of the budget line with the highest possible indifference curve point Q in figure. So at the point of tangent, the slope of the budget line is PX by PY. Of the indifference curve, MRS XY is equal to MUX by MUY are equal, that is MUX upon by MUY is equal to PX upon by PY. Thus the first order condition is denoted graphically by the point of tangency of the two relevant curves. The second order condition is implied by the convex slope of the indifference curve, the previous slide diagram, where the intersection of the budget line and the highest possible indifference curve to getting the consumer maximum satisfaction, that is the consumer equilibrium, is equals to MRSXY is equals to MUX upon by MUY equals to PX upon by PY. The slope of indifference curve is equals to the slope of budget line, so that the consumer has to get the maximum satisfaction giving his prices, giving his income to getting the commodities. So next we will go to another theory, the most important revealed preference hypothesis. So Samuelson introduced the term revealed preference into economics in 1938. The revealed preference hypothesis considered as a major breakthrough in the theory of demand because it has made possible the establishment of the law of demand directly without the use of indifference curve, all their strategic assumptions. So you can observe the basic assumptions of the revealed preference theory is, one is the rationality, another one is the consistency and transitivity and revealed preference point. So you can look at rationality in this revealed preference hypothesis. If the consumer is assumed to behave rational in that he preferred bundles of the goods that include more quantities of the commodities. So you can look at in this assumption, this assumption is repeated both theories, in the consumer indifference theory and revealed preference theory. But preferences are, consumer is always a rational manner. Second assumption is consistency. If the consumer behaves consistently, that is, if he chooses the bundle A, a situation in which bundle V is always available to him, he will not choose B in any other situation in which A is also available symbolically. That means if A greater than B, then B cannot greater than A. third one is transitivity. If any particular situation, A greater than B, B greater than C, then A always greater than C. What is that implication? If the consumer has to prefer A greater than B and B greater than C, then A greater than always C. The revealed preference axiom. So this is revealed preference axiom. The consumer, by choosing a collection of the goods in any budget situation, reveal his preference for this particular collection. Chosen bundle is revealed to be preferred among all other alternative bundles available under budget constraint. So in this assumption, the revealed preference for a particular collection of the goods implies the maximization of the utility of the consumer. So the consumer, by choosing collection of the goods in any one budget situation, reveals his preferences for this particular collection. He shows bundle is revealed to preferred among all other alternative bundles available under the budget constraint. So you can derive the demand curve on the according to the assumptions. So assumption that the consumer has to budget line AB in figure 2.15 and chooses the collection of goods denoted by the point Z. Thus revealing his preferences for this batch, suppose that the price of good X falls, that new budget line facing consumer AC is AC. Right? That means initial budget line AB, if the price of the good X is declining, the budget will shift to rightward, that is the AC. We will show that new batch or the new line will include the large quantity of X, the quantity of Y is constant. According to that, you can derive the demand curve. Right? If the price of the good X declining, the budget line shifted to leftward, that is the AC to some other curve. Right? So next you can derive the indifference curve. Although not needed for establish the law of demand, indifference curve can be derived and their conviction provided by the revealed preference hypothesis. Samuelson revealed preference theory does not require for consumer to rank his preferences or to give any other information about this test. The revealed preferences permits us to construct the indifference map of the consumer just by observing his behavior. His choice has various market prices, provided that L, his choice is consistent. M, his tests are independent of his choices over time to do not change. That is key point. That the consumer is rational in the Pareto sense, that is, he preferred more to goods less. Critics of the revealed preference hypothesis. As per as our analysis, we have already said that Samuelson revealed preference theory is a major advancement of the theory of demand. It provides a direct way to the derivation of the demand curve, which does not require the use of the concept of utility. The theory can prove the existence and conviction of the indifference curves under weaker assumption than the earlier theories. So according to these theories, you can discuss some important consumer behavior theories, that is the consumer indifference curve and revealed preference theory. Both theories have to express how the consumer has been getting the maximum satisfaction. You can use the different bundles of the goods. So according to this syllabus, and we have to given the some readings, suggested readings. One is the A. Coutts and Nies, and N. G. Mankiw, and Joseph Stiglitz and Case and Fayre. And another most required books are Case and Fayre and Stiglitz. You can refer. And some other competitive exams, you can find out the some questions in this area, in this syllabus, according to the lecture. So you can discuss some important questions, right? So question is asked some examination. Economists associated with the development of indifference curve analysis are, that is, Hicks and Allen, Hicks and Robbins, Marshall Hicks, and Hicks and Walras. This answer is Marshall and Hicks. Second question, other things remaining the same, when a consumer income rises, his equilibrium point moves at, what is the answer? There are four options: A higher indifference curve, a lower indifference curve, remain unchanged at the same indifference curve, moves the left hand side on the same indifference curve. Here the second question answer is A higher indifference curve. And third question is, ordinal approach is based on law of maximum satisfaction. Utility could not be measured in cardinal numbers, utility could not be measured in ordinal numbers, utility can be measured. Here in this question answer is B. Utility could not be measured the cardinal numbers. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गुड्स एक्स एंड वाई आर परफेक्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट ए कंज्यूमर इंडिफरेंस कर्व फॉर दीज कमोडिटीज इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई ए अपवर्ड स्लोपिंग स्ट्राइट लाइन अपवर्ड स्लोपिंग कर्व विच इज कॉन्वेक्स फ्रॉम बिलो डाउनवर्ड स्लोपिंग स्ट्राइट लाइन एंड डाउनवर्ड स्लोपिंग कर्व विच इज कॉन्वेक्स टू द ऑरिजिन इन दिस क्वेश्चन द आंसर इज डाउनवर्ड स्लोपिंग स्ट्राइट लाइन एंड फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन द रिवील्ड प्रेफरेंस थ्योरी इज बेस्ड ऑन ऑप्शन आर द एजम्पशन ऑफ इंडिफरेंस ए एंड बी ऑप्शन यूटिलिटी एंड डिमांड सी ऑप्शन इंट्रोस्पेक्शन एंड डी ऑप्शन ऑब्जर्व्ड कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर एंड द आंसर इज इन दिस फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन ऑब्जर्व्ड कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर एंड सिक्स्थ क्वेश्चन समटाइम दे कैन आस्क सिंपल क्वेश्चन रिवील्ड प्रेफरेंस थ्योरी वॉज फॉर्मुलेटेड लियोनेल रॉबिन्स पॉल सैम्युएलसन जॉन रॉबिन्सन एंड अल्फ्रेड मार्शल इन दिस क्वेश्चन द आंसर इज पॉल सैम्युएलसन ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस इन द लेक्चर एंड थैंक यू फॉर योर अटेंशन थैंक यू वेरी मच इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर यूवर फ्रेंड्स एंड आफ्टर फॉलोइंग दिस क्लास आई हैव टू डिस्कस अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स थियरी ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन एंड द मार्केट स्ट्रक्चर एंड व्हाट इज द इनकम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड डिफरेंट डिफरेंट थियरीज इन द राइट रेंट वेजेस एंड ऑल्सो वी कैन डिस्कसिंग एंडोजेनस ग्रोथ थियरी right some other important topics we have to discuss thank you very much thank you